Good morning, children. So let us come back to your today's class. The previous class, we have gone through a new lesson, that is, the best advice I ever had, written by Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit. So the incidents what we came across that topic was the attitude of Mrs. Pandit towards the society, means that day's existing or prevailing social conditions, and her trust on Gandhiji. Gandhiji has given an advice to her that before leaving to the foreign country, you have to go and meet your relatives and be in good terms with them. But what reply she had given is, no, not at all. Even to please you, I am not going to meet them. So we have completed up to that. Today, let us see what is the next topics, next incidents what we are going through. So children, open your textbook, page number 3 and paragraph 9. Same time, keep a pencil with you to note the meanings. Have you taken both pencil and opened the textbook? Yeah. So come back. So let us continue. Okay. His words would not leave me. They gave me no peace. After some days of severe struggle with myself, I finally telephoned to my brother-in-law. I would like to see you and the family, I said before leaving. His words would not leave me. Means what? Gandhiji's words. What was the words? That you have to go and meet your relatives before leaving to the foreign country, that is to America. So that words was torturing her a lot. So they gave me no peace. So she couldn't sleep peacefully. And after some days of severe struggle with myself, I finally telephoned my brother-in-law. What she has written here? So after some days of thinking what to do, finally she decided to telephone her brother-in-law. I would like to see you and the family, I said before leaving. So what she told her? See, before leaving to America, I want to see you and your family. So that was her words. Understood, children? Yeah. So let us see the next. Having been with them 5 minutes before, I sensed that my visit had brought a feeling of relief to everyone. I told them of my plans and asked for their good wishes before starting on his new stage of my life. The effect on me was miraculous. I felt as if a great burden had been lifted and I was free to be myself. So children, underline these words. First line, I sensed, the end of the first line, sensed, meaning is felt, F-E-L-T, felt. Next, the fourth line, somewhere at the middle, fourth line, miraculous, that is wonderful, miraculous, wonderful. Have you written? Yeah. Now let us see. I hadn't being with them 5 minutes before I sensed that my visit had brought a feeling of relief to everyone. So what she mean to say is, see, after a long time's thinking, she went to her brother-in-law's house. And what she could find is, she reached there and spent 5 minutes time there. Then she could realize that how everyone are. They were longing to meet her. How much they were longing to meet her. Because all were very happy and they felt very relaxed by seeing her. That is what she could understood. Then I told them of my plans and asked for their good wishes before starting on this new stage of my life. So what she did? She told them that, see, I am going to America and I spend my life there. I wish to spend my life in America. And what I am going to do there, I am going as a commissioner of the General Assembly to attend certain conferences there. The effect on me was miraculous. I felt as if a great burden had been lifted and I was free to be myself. So what she meant to convince us is that after talking with them for a certain time, she felt very relieved. Because till that time, she was thinking that her relatives are not supporting her, means moral support. They are not giving her the moral support and nobody is there to help her. She is helpless after her husband's death. But after talking for a few minutes with them, she felt that all her burden have been relieved. She is now peaceful in her mind. Got it, children? Okay. Now let us see the next. This small gesture was the beginning of a significant change in me. A year and a half later, I was in New York as a leader of the Indian delegation to the United Nations. Important to us was India's complaint regarding the treatment of people of Indian origin in South Africa. Harsh things were said by both sides. I resented the manner in which my opponents made personal attacks harmful to India's prestige and to mine. I struck back with the same sharp weapon. So let us see once. First you underline the words, okay? The first line, beginning, jester. Underline the word jester. Action. Action. Then third line. Sorry, not third line, sixth line. Starting. Resented. Resented. Right there. Got angry. Got angry. Then the second last line, last. Struck back. Struck back. Underlined. Reacted. Reacted. Then the last word. Sharp weapon. Underlined. That is the way. Sharp weapon. The way. The manner. Rude manner. Written? Okay. Now let us see. This small gesture was the beginning of a significant change in me. So what she was saying, only once she visited them, and she got all the support from her family members, relatives. So this was a great relief for her. It made a significant change in her. A year and a half later, I was in New York. So what she was telling, after that incident, 1.5 years after that, she was in New York. She went to New York as a leader of the Indian delegation to the United Nations. So she went to represent India in New York. So to represent what? Important to us was India's complaints regarding the treatment of people of Indian origin in South Africa. So why she went there? She wanted to talk about the treatment of Indian people in South Africa. They were not treated equally in that country. So to talk about this, as an Indian representative, she went to New York to attend a conference. Now, harsh things were said by both sides. So what she is saying, even from her side, that is Indian side and the South Africans or the New York people committee who were there to participate in this conference, to attend the conference, they were criticizing each other very harshly. I resented the manner in which my opponents made personal attacks, harmful to India's prestige and to mine. So what she is saying is, see, when the others, the opponent means opposite party, when the opposite party, the opposite group talked very rudely about India and Indians, it hurted her very much. And so what she did, she reacted in a very angry way, in a very rude way, somewhat in the equal status of words what they have used. Got it? Then, I struck back with the same sharp weapon. That means what? She reacted in the same manner how the others talked about India and the Indians. Got it, children? Okay, once again, read that. This small gesture was the beginning of a significant change in me. A year and a half later, I was in New York as a leader of the Indian delegation to the United Nations. Important to us was India's complaints regarding the treatment of people of Indian origin in South Africa. Harsh things were said by both sides. I resented the manner in which my opponents made personal attacks, harmful to India's prestige and to me. I struck back with the same sharp weapon. Got it, children? Okay. Now let us go to the next. Then, after a distressing duel of words, I suddenly thought of Gandhiji. Would he approve? To him, means were as important as the end. In the long run, perhaps more important. What if we succeeded in getting our resolution passed by questionable tactics that injured our self-respect? So what she told in the previous paragraph was, she reacted in the same way, with the same tone, how the opponents, the opposite party, were talking. So after that, what happened? She felt a little worried. What Gandhiji may think about me? Gandhi always likes to keep peacefulness, likes to maintain peacefulness with everyone. So, what he thinks by hearing my voice like this? So, let us see. First, you underline the words. the first line, dual. Dual of words. That is clashing, clashing of words. Did? Yeah. Next, the fourth line, middle. Resolution. Resolution. Meaning is demand, decision. Demand or a decision. Written? Yeah. Now, let us see. Then, after a distressing duel of words, I suddenly thought of Gandhiji. So, after retreating, reacting in the same way, how they have talked. So, after that, what happened? She remembered about Gandhiji. Would he approve? So, what she remembered? Oh, if I talk like this, Gandhiji likes that or not? What he thinks of me? To him, means were as important as the ant. So, what she is saying? For Gandhiji, whatever we want to achieve, that is as important as how we achieve it. Because he likes always be in peace with everyone. Perhaps more important. So, what is his thing? Means how we achieve the things, that is important. That is even more important than what we achieve. Then, what if we succeeded in getting our resolutions passed by questionable tactics that injured our self-respect? So, what she is saying, according to Gandhiji, if we gain something after insulting ourselves, that's not good. That cannot be considered as a gain. So, we have to achieve something in a respectful way. We should gain it from others. We have to achieve it from others in a very, very respectful way. So, that is the motto of Gandhiji. Understood, children? Yeah. Let us go to the next paragraph. Before going to bed that night, I resolved that come what might, no word of mine would be lightly used in the UN. From then on, I lifted the debate back to where it belonged, refusing to retaliate to personal attacks or to score a cheap point. Our opponents met us on the new level, and from then we argued the case on its merits. So, what she is telling, let us see, before that underline this meaning. The third line, last, retaliate, retaliate, that is react, react, written, yeah, let us see. Before going to bed that night, so one day they held the conference and both the parties, they talked in a very rude way. The same day at night, before going to the bed, what she is saying? Before going to bed that night, I resolved that come what might. But I decided, let it come, whatever it is, I'm not bothered. Okay. That come what might, no word of mine would be likely used in the UN. But I'm not going to use rash words or rude words in the UN hereafter. Let it be what Gandhiji think about that. Okay. Okay. Leave it. But now onwards, I'm not going to talk in a rude way here. Then, from then on, I lifted the debate back to where it belonged. So, further, the next day onwards, how she talked, she tried to stick on to the topic. She never used a rude word again. And refusing to retaliate, to personal attacks, or to score a cheap point. So, for gaining something, to win them, okay, or to succeed over them. Again, she never used a harsh word to them. Our opponents met us on the new level, and from then we argued the case on its merits. So what she is saying, when she stopped talking rude words, even the opponents, opposite team, even they became calm. Even they talked very decently with her. Understood, children? Yeah, next. Before leaving the committee room on the last day, I went up and spoke to the leader of the opposing delegation. I have come to ask you to forgive me if I have hurt you by any word or action in this debate. So what happened next day? See, before leaving the committee room on the last day, so many days the conference were there, then the both the parties, they talked about the condition of the Indian people in South Africa, their problems, their issues, whatever they are facing, all they discussed. And at the last day of the conference meeting, before leaving the committee room on the last day, I went up and spoke to the leader of the opposing delegation. Delegation means group. Delegation, group. So what she is saying, before leaving, after the conference, she went to the room of the other parties, the other groups leader. And what happens? I have come to ask you to forgive me if I have hurt you by any word or action in this debate. So what she told her, see, I came here now to talk to you. What? I plead you, you forgive me if I talked anything rudely to you. To ask you forgiveness, I came here now. Next, he shook my hand warmly and said, I have no complaints. So what? She didn't expect. She expected that the person may get angry and he may use rude words. But what happened was just opposite to that. So he shook my hand warmly and said, I have no complaints. So what he did, he shook her hand and told her, no, no problem. I don't have any complaints. When you people fight with your friends in the class or in the school and talk with them very rudely sometimes, no, after sometimes your another friend may tell you, no, you go and ask him sorry, or your teacher may tell you, go and ask sorry with him. No, so you will do, you will go to that person and you will ask them, no, the forgiveness. This is what happened here also. It was good to feel right with him, but even better to feel right with myself. Once more, Gandhiji's advice had saved me from myself. So how she concludes it, see, it was good to feel right with him. So what she is telling, to be in right terms, good terms with him was good, but even better to feel right with myself. So after apologizing with him, she felt very peacefulness. So that is what she is saying, that I felt better myself. Then, once more, Gandhiji's advice had saved me from myself. So what she is telling, in this situation also, what saved her, it was nothing but Gandhiji's advice. To be in peace with everyone and leave your egos. That was the advice given by Gandhiji. We have seen in the last class, previous class. So that advice saved her here also. Understood, children? Yeah, that's enough today. Okay? So, do I want to read it again? I don't think so. It is all simple words. You can go through this, and if any words you couldn't understand, okay, and when you read you can't understand, please ask me, okay, or put the word in the post and I'll respond to you. Okay, children, so you have to go through the text today itself once again, okay, and try to understand that. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.